Batanes is the smallest province in the Philippines, but it is in no way little when it comes to beauty and charm. This 10-piece archipelago has so many spectacular sights to offer to lucky visitors. A tour around Bataan Island alone has the ability to make you question whether you're awake or dreaming, because Batanes is dreamy, fantastic, and surreal. Hi, we are Vince and Josh. In our previous video, we shared with you the best attractions in the northern half of Batanes main island. This time, we're heading south for more picturesque beaches, more rolling hills, and more incredible views. South Bataan covers a wider area and takes an entire day. It straddles the municipalities of Mahataw, Ivana, and Uyugan, but in my opinion, it is much more breathtaking than the north. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. Here are some sites that you shouldn't miss when you tour South Bataan. Chawa View Deck. Chawa View Deck allows a gorgeous view of the western cliffs of Bataan Island facing the West Philippine Sea. From here, the Basco Lighthouse or Naidi Hills can also be spotted. It is usually the first stop of the South Bataan tour, an ideal choice because it offers a quick glimpse of what's to come. Tayid Lighthouse. Tayid Lighthouse in Mahataw is one of the three beacons erected in Batanes in year 2000. Although part of the same project, Tayid Lighthouse is very different from its Basco counterpart. Basco Lighthouse is rounded, while Tayid is hexagonal. The former overlooks the West Philippine Sea, while Tayid keeps an eye on the Pacific Ocean. You can walk around the lighthouse and admire the stunning view. Raku Apayaman. Raku Apayaman is more popularly called Marlborough Country by tourists. Verdant rolling hills serve as the grazing and resting spots for our bovine friends and a marvelous viewpoint for visitors.
One more tip if you're visiting Marlborough Country here in Batanes. If you decide to go down there, make sure you have the energy to climb back up because it's quite a test of stamina.
It is one of those places where you can just sit, relax, and wallow in the utter peace and beauty before you. Pick a hill crest and you'll have the most picture-perfect view of the Tayid Lighthouse to the left, Mount Iraya to the right, and the Ura Beach in between. Absolutely wonderful! Imnabu Beach. Lying right across the San Lorenzo Ruiz Chapel is Barangay Imnabu in Uyugan. It is a sand and shingle beach where locals obtain the stones they use for their homes. Vines crawl seaward on the gently sloping shore, which is bookmarked by rocky promontories. It may not be a good spot for swimming, but it is definitely snap-worthy. Alapad Pass and Mochong Viewpoint. In this part of Bataan Island, the road cuts through a small hill forming what they call Alapad Pass. A few meters from here rises a view deck that gives another stellar vista of the beaches on both sides. Massive rocks speck the surrounding waters too. The ruins of the old USCG Loran Station or Long Range Naval Station, set to be opened as a museum, are also within easy reach from here. The station was the center of what used to be Little America during the American era. Sitio Songsong. The ruins of Sitio Songsong is what remains of the barangay when a tsunami slapped Batanes in 1954. While you're here, feel the wind in your face and walk along the beach. It's not the finest, but it's a great view nonetheless. Honesty Coffee Shop. Unmanned and always open, the Honesty Shop is a sari-sari store and coffee shop that puts so much trust on its customers. You get what you want and drop your payment at designated boxes, a testament to the admirable values of the locals. In a province that boasts virtually zero crime rate, stealing is almost unheard of. This can also serve as your rest stop. Instant coffee and cup noodles are available along with other snacks. House of Dakay. Built in 1887, the House of Dakay is the oldest surviving stone house in Batanes. It is one of the only five houses that remain standing after an 8.3 magnitude earthquake that leveled the town of Ivana in September 1918. Of the five, it is the only one that remains unchanged. not including the thatched Kogon roof that has to be replaced every 30 years. Nearby is an old Spanish bridge that is still used today. Homoron Blue Lagoon. Homoron Blue Lagoon is also known as the Spaniard's Lagoon or Spanish Lagoon because back in the Spanish era, only they were allowed to take a dip here. Today, of course, it is open to everyone who wants a refreshing time without battling the bullying waves that are present in almost every beach in the province. Maydangeb White Beach. Just a short walk from Homoron Blue Lagoon is the so-called White Beach, with gentler waves and shallower waters compared to other beaches on the island. The White Beach and the Blue Lagoon are perfect for swimming and picnics. But not all tours allow much time in the itinerary. If you want to swim in either side, make sure to inform the tour operator so they can adjust the itinerary for you. If swimming is allowed, make sure to bring a towel, swimming attire, and extra clothes. San Carlos Borromeo Church. Every municipality in Batanes has its own church and you can stop at each of them if you want. Just inform your guide. But the San Carlos Borromeo Church in Mahataw is the most culturally significant. It was constructed in 1873 by Onesimo Polo. The church is declared a cultural icon by the National Commission for Culture and the Arts and the National Museum. Mahataw Boat Shelter. Completed in October 2005, this 130 million boat shelter port was the biggest infrastructure project by the provincial government at the time. It serves as shelter to vessels bound for Itbayat and other boats during inclement weather. Most tours pull over by the roadside, so tourists can admire and appreciate the view. But it's usually just a quick stop. Diura Village. Diura Village is not part of the usual South Bataan itinerary, but it is possible to visit this if you have more time. Diura Village is a small fishing community 3 kilometers from the town proper of Mahataw facing the Pacific. The village is best known for its gorgeous landscapes and the traditional ritual that is performed at the start of the fishing season to avoid accidents and to attract a more bountiful catch, mostly dolphin fish or arayu and flying fish or dibang. That's all for South Bataan Tour. The sheer number of stops makes this an exhausting tour, but you won't be complaining because this will definitely leave you breathless. If you need more information about traveling to and around Batanes, check out the comprehensive travel guides on our blog, www.thepoortraveler.net. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you won't miss any of our future videos. We're Vince and Josh. See you again next time. Plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.